Here come the lifeguards, keeping us safe when we're on the beach or out at sea. On the East Coast, they've dealt with more than 400 incidents this summer.
Now, I'm not the world's greatest swimmer, but I've been given the chance to train as a lifeguard. So let's see if I've got what it takes.
I'm in Bridlington, one of our biggest beaches. When the sun shines, this place gets packed, but help is always at hand. I'm joining the lifeguards who spend the summer making sure holidaymakers stay safe and sound. Helen Peterson and Ryan Hepworth are lifeguards on Bridlington's South Beach, which stretches from the harbour all the way south to Fraythorpe.
So what would be a typical day at work for you, Ryan?
We're down here 10 till 6 every day. Just kind of looking after people, trying to prevent accidents before they happen, hopefully, and making sure everyone's safe and having a fun day.
So what's in store for me today, then?
We're just going to teach you how we enter the water, how we approach the casualty, how we bring them back into shore and how we carry them ashore, because obviously they're unconscious, so they can't walk for themselves, so we're going to teach you a lift that we use to get them ashore.
Right. I've got the gear, so let's get started.
Now I'm beginning to look like a lifeguard, time for some training.
OK, what we're going to do today is we're going to teach you how to do an unconscious tube rescue. Okay. This is our rescue tube, which is the basic piece of equipment that all our lifeguards carry. So if you want to have a little feel of it, it's nice and light,
yep,
and foamy. Obviously that gives the buoyancy to the casualty when we're picking them up. As you see, we've got a rope around here and it's wrapped around. If we just pull on here and throw the thing behind us, when we're ready to go, we can just put it over our shoulder, run in the water, start swimming, it'll just drag along behind us, and then we're ready to reach the casualty. Make sure you've got a good, strong...
It's getting tougher. Another lifeguard, Jen Robinson, is pretending to be a swimmer who needs help.
Ready, steady, lift.
That's it, yep. OK, then you want to swing your bum in.
Yep.
That's it. There we go. Ooh. Ready, steady, walk. Then we're going to lower down to one knee. Ready, steady, lower. That's it. And then if you take her hands, you're going to need to take all her weight. She's unconscious. Yep. And then if we lower her down, that's it. Lower. Fantastic.
It's quite strenuous, isn't it? You need a lot of, yeah. I don't know how I'm going to do that in the water. So I actually need to get into the water, and there's a special way of doing this, right?
We do a thing called chicken legs, which is basically how we run into the water without catching our feet on the water and tripping over, basically.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll
do a very quick demonstration to start with. Okay. So it's really just running, but keeping your knees high, okay? So run along, lift our knees out of the water, like so.
Okay.
Okay?
Here goes. This is the fastest way to run across shallow water. It just looks a little silly. On the beach, even in shallow water, conditions can be deceptive.
We've had a megaphone announcement just to let these guys know the safest place to swim is between the red and yellow flags over there. So we do have a bit of a current going on today, so they're all drifting down.
Most incidents are painful but routine. This girl's sprained her ankle. A boy's cut his finger on a piece of glass. This little boy needs to be brought back after drifting out to sea.
Make sure you stay between the red and yellow flags and try not to go that far out, OK? If you can't touch the floor, come back in towards the beach.
Back to the training, and I've got a confession to make. I've never swum in the North Sea before, but now I've got to dive in.
You've done the chicken legs until you get to over knee depth,
okay,
to get you into that level, and at that point you're going to start using the dolphin dives to get you through the next chunk of water until you get to a point where you can swim.
And is your head going underneath the water?
The head is going under the water, so you're using the sand, you're jumping off the sand, diving through the wave, hitting the sand again, your hands are in front, so that hits the ground first, and then you can almost pull on the ground to bring your legs through, ready to push up for the next one.
Okay,
first, Ryan shows me how it should be done. I don't think it's as easy as it looks.
I'm not going to have to do this.
Just remember to breathe that through your nose when you do it. Do you want to do it together, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
Set, go.
I can't do one, you're my falling one!
We're off. I don't know about Helen and Ryan, but I'm finding it hard work.
So I've done the training and we're in the water, so now I'm going to try and rescue someone. I'm a lifeguard, can you hear me?
Jen's pretending to be a holidaymaker in trouble. It's up to me to help her.
Okay, I'm just checking whether she's breathing. And she is. So So now I'm going to try and swim it back to shore.
Now comes the final task, to get the casualty out of the water. We've got to pick her up and try not to drop her. We're spreading the weight on both our shoulders. It takes balance and a fair bit of strength.
Stop. Ready, steady, rotate. OK, we're going to go down to one knee. Ready, steady, lower.
Well, it was my first attempt. I think I need a little more practice.
I'm a terrible lifeguard. So how do you think I did? Would I be a potential lifeguard?
I think you grasped the basics really quickly and really well. Obviously, you probably need to work on your dolphin diving a little bit more and just obviously takes a lot of training to get your fitness up to the right standard. So if you're prepared to put in the hours on your fitness, you never know.
A diplomatic answer.
Everyone gets worried when a child might have gone into the sea. Today, there's an alert on the beach. A 7-year-old girl's gone missing. As a search begins, lifeguard Jen joins the girl's father on the beach.
This gentleman's lost his little girl, so we've got all the lifeguards out looking for them. We've got someone out on the quad bike, someone staying in the patrol zone looking for her, someone doing bay sobs, and we're going to head up onto soft sand and have a wander, see if we can find her.
The father's getting increasingly concerned. It's 15 minutes since he last saw his daughter.
We seem to have searched the majority of the area, so I recommend probably getting the police involved. It's a good idea, over.
She's running toward the water, last time you saw her.
The little girl's been missing for half an hour, and the search is intensifying.
I'm currently with the father just by the spa on the promenade with some of the police officers. We're just waiting for the Coast Guard to come down, and then they're going to organise a proper search along the beach, over.
The father thinks he might have spotted her, but it turns out to be a false alarm.
Just put yourselves in the biggest gap for the police.
Yeah.
All right.
Jen gets some new information from the missing girl's brother, and it sounds worrying.
The little boy, who was his son, was the last person to be with the missing child. Yeah. And he said, his dad said, oh, was she in the water? And he said, yeah. And then he said, what happened to her? And he said, his response was, because he's only four, she just disappeared like magic. So yeah. I don't know whether she's gone into the sea or whether she's come back onto the beach.
It's an hour since the missing girl disappeared. Everyone's getting increasingly concerned. It's a huge beach and it's crowded with people, but so far, the 7-year-old seems to have vanished without a trace. Finally, after 2 hours, it sounds like good news.
As you look at the beach, as far as you can see, we're at Fraythorpe Beach, which is where the child was reported found by a farmer that has a farm up there. They contacted the Coast Guard. The Coast Guard have just got down there and confirmed that it was the missing child, so they're sending the parents down to reunite them now.
Thankfully, this time, there's a happy ending. For all of us, it's been another busy day at the seaside.